Live from historic Fenway Park in Boston, we've got baseball on the show. It's the Cleveland Guardians and the Boston Red Sox. First pitch coming your way next. So almost ready to get underway, and on the hill today, Cutter Crawford. How about a report on him, Chris?
Try to stay back for that power changeup. Speed differential between the fastball and the changeup is huge. Hitters, they have a hard time staying back.
Here's the left fielder, Stephen Kwan.
He's a bad ball hitter, so even if you get him to chase pitches outside the zone, he still might beat you. Not an easy out by any means.
Slice the other way. That's a base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Well, they call that an advantage count for a reason. You're so much more likely to get something you can handle. I don't know how he's able to shoot that pitch the other way and still put something on. That pitch was inside, and he let it get really deep, so pretty incredible hands to fight it off and still get good wood on it.
Digging in, Miles Straw. The 2-1. High fly ball out into left center field. Squeezes it. Here's the Guardians lineup now. And now it's Josh Naylor. Obviously a guy who makes good contact, hits for average, but one of the things in today's game, the value in the fact that he hits both righties and lefties. That one the other way, and a base hit. Lead runner makes the turn at second, and they'll have runners at the corners after a one-out single.
That was a thing of beauty. He may have been a little behind the pitch, but by getting that barrel into the hitting zone early on in his swing, he was able to meet it and still shoot a line drive down the line and left.
Now it's Jose Ramirez. Two on, one out.
That's ball two.
Could be some action here on this next pitch. Couple runners on. Probably a challenge pitch coming. Well, all eyes on the double play ball in this spot. No better way to get out of this inning.
Ramirez swings and blasts one. Deep to right field. That one back. Get out of town. And it gives him the lead in the first. It's 3-0.
Boog, his plan was to hit the ball hard, and he was going to figure out the rest later. You can't argue with those results. He's so good at getting his arms extended, and that's exactly what he did right there. You don't typically want to pull a pitch in that part of the plate, but he doesn't allow his wrists to roll over, stays through the ball, gets the loft, and gets the home run.
Will Brennan digs in for the Guardians. Battling here as he fouls it away. Already three runs across in the frame, and we're just getting started here in the top of the first. Ground ball right side. Slings to first, and there's two down.
Batting fifth, the catcher, Bo Naylor.
Two outs, base is empty. Bo Naylor at the plate now. Oh. So a foul ball makes it 1-2.
Well, with this many pitches thrown here in this first inning, I mean, you're giving the other team a really good look. He's going to have to find a way to get some weak contact, maybe a swing and miss, get into that dugout and hit the reset button.
That one just misses. The count now 2-2.
It's a good take.
Swings through that, and it's a strikeout. That's the third out. Jose Ramirez with the homer here. It's now 3-0. It's Major League Baseball, and it's on the show. Back here with my pal Ziggy. Now the starting pitcher in this one, Xavien Curry. What do we need to know here about the right-hander?
Four-pitch guy. He's got some options to work with in terms of keeping hitters off balance. So we'll see how he decides to utilize those weapons through this start here and whether or not he's able to mix them all in early or if he wants to hold something back a little bit later, maybe second, third time through the order, and give them something they haven't seen. It's tough when you know a guy's got that in his back pocket as a hitter.
Time now to check out the lineup for the Boston Red Sox. Already they find themselves down 3 runs in this game, so there's work to be done.
Yeah, you want to see them come out with a little urgency here. You don't have to score all 3 runs, but put something up on the board, and that'll make you feel a little bit better about your opportunities. But if you're looking at that 3-run lead and saying we've got to get it right now, you can put yourself up against a wall and not have really good at bats. So just trust the process. Trust that your pitcher can hold them right there. These players could find themselves back in this ballgame.
One down, base is empty. Swings through it, and that's a strikeout.
Batting third.
Now batting Tristan Casas. And the righty deals. And another ball. Two outs, base is empty. He goes down looking. Red Sox go down quietly. They trail in this one 3-0. And we're back. Here's Brian Rocchio.
The shortstop, Brian Rocchio.
The wind and the pitch. Swings through that one for strike two.
He has a tendency to chase out of the zone, and that slider that's down, that's one of his money pitches to get that swing and miss.
Ripped to third and caught.
That swing right there tells me he's seeing the ball pretty well. I know it didn't produce a hit, but he made solid contact, and that's all you're looking to do anytime you're at the plate.
Here's Andrés Giménez. And the right-hander deals. That one ripped. O'Neill going back on it. Pulls it in on the warning track. Two outs, base is empty. Laureano comes up to hit. And another ball. Next offering is in for a strike. Flares it into the outfield. Makes the play, and it's out number 3. Guardians fail to score, but they lead it 3-0. Second, and now the DH, Masataka Yoshida.
Masataka Yoshida.
The wind to kick the pitch. This one popped up. Jimenez under it. Hauls it in for the out. And there's one down.
Batting fifth, the shortstop, Trevor Story.
Here's Trevor Story. You talk about elite defensive players, especially in the middle of the diamond, and this guy is at the top of the list. And the pitch. And that one is lifted in the air. Laureano makes the grab, two away.
Batting sixth, the right fielder, Willier.
And the batter now, Willier Abreu. Popped up to the left, into foul ground. Brings it in, and that'll do it. Nothing doing for the offense that time. We head on now to the top of the third. Guardians 3 and the Red Sox nothing. Back now at Fenway. New inning getting started. So in now for Cleveland, Stephen Kwan. Next offering is in for a strike.
Been a rough start on the mound for this guy. His third inning is so important for him to get on track, turn the page, settle in, do all those things you need to do to give your team a little bit of length in this one.
And a pitch. Liner, base hit. And the leadoff man aboard.
Couple of hits in a row for him here. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
Nobody out. Runner at first. Pitch misses there. 2-2.
Two balls, two strikes.
And down on strikes he goes, and one gone.
Well, that at-bat seemed to be over as soon as it started. Three-pitch strikeout. You've got to be better at the plate right there, at least to foul something off, extend that at-bat.
Here's Josh Naylor. Kwan leads off first with one away. And a pitch out, but nothing going on. And a pitch. Runner on the go. Fouls one off. 2-2. Runner goes again. Pitch misses inside. Throw to second. Tag. And they got him.
Well, you can get away a little bit with not being so accurate when you've got such a great arm and you get rid of it quickly. And that's what happened right there. He made up for the lack of accuracy with excellent velocity. Nice job with the catch and throw right there.
Two outs. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Three balls, two strikes, the count. Well struck, right field. That's down. One hops off the wall. Safely into second. He's got a double.
Everything came together perfectly for him right there. Just a solid swing right there. Caught it out front and ripped it into the outfield for the base hit. Those always feel great.
Here's Jose Ramirez. Man at second. Foul ball there.
And the strategy of winning a ball game, when you could make that pitcher work a little more, expose himself by throwing pitches, that could be the key to winning perhaps later on. So good job of extending this inning, getting a knock with two outs to bring the number four home hitter up.
And it stays fair. Naylor rounds third, headed for the plate. The throw into second. The tag out. That ends the inning, but they do score a run here. One run on three hits. No errors. No one left. We move on to the bottom of inning number three. Guardians 4 and the Red Sox nothing. Back here at Fenway, here's Tyler O'Neill. The 1-1. Down the right field line, that's a base hit. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
He really shot that one down the right field line and somehow found a way to keep it from slicing foul. One thing that was great about the approach, his head was down all the way through the pitch, and that's how you do it.
Vaughn Grissom up next for the Red Sox. In there for a strike at the top of the zone. The Guardians leading by four here in the last half of the third. Now a high fly ball out to left center. Straw getting an angle on it. Straw makes the catch. What about the fans at Fenway? Would they let you have it from time to time?
They're definitely intelligent baseball fans, which is awesome. They're not waiting for something to happen. They can smell a big inning or anticipate a situation setting itself up.
And there he goes. That's in for a strike. Bro, and they got him.
That's just a perfect catch and throw right there. You get a guy with that kind of speed trying to take second. He's got such a good arm back there, but that had to be on the money. Pressure situation, if you will, right on top of it.
And another ball.
One thing I found that was very cool was making a great play to end the inning and running off the field and getting a standing ovation, even at times when you're not a player on their team. As long as you're not winning, they will celebrate and applaud a great play on the field. These fans here, they love and respect baseball.
Center fielder, number 16, Jaren.
Now batting Jaren Duran. The 1-1 is fouled off. And a ball and two strikes. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again.
Very dominant with that fastball inside. Hitter's going to be conscious of that. Now you have the outer half of the plate to work with out there on the mound.
At the belt and fires. Line drive. Laureano makes the catch, and that ends the inning. And the Red Sox leave one. They're on the short end of a 4-0 score. And we're back leave here at Fenway Park. Out of the fourth, the now it's hitter. The DH, Will Brennan.
So, Boog, you went to college in this town. What was it like for you being a college student and having the opportunity to bounce over here to Fenway Park and see some games?
Yeah, in fact, 1990, a couple of swings here and blasts one left field, and it bangs off the monster.
Love how he let that ball travel, trusted his hands. Nice job of going the other way.
So, man aboard, Bo Naylor getting ready to hit. Ball to strike. The pitch. Fouled off left side.
He's mixing his pitches really well. Late on that fastball after seeing the changeup. See if he can elevate one. I think if he does, he'll get the swing and miss.
That's inside. Two and two. Check on the runner. Back standing. He's in there safely. kick, Sandios. Swung on, belted. Makes a move towards the gap. And it one-hops the wall. And that's a double. Brennan around third. Out at the plate. And the batter will be the shortstop, Ryan Rocchio. Just missed. Kicks and fires.
That's ball three.
Well, the good thing so far is that he hasn't issued any free passes. Unfortunately, they're making pretty good contact, so not getting the swings and misses and making that defense work behind him.
And that's ball four. And now Andrés Giménez. We talk about guys with good speed, and definitely he has it. But pushing the offense aside for just a second, Chris, it's the defensive side that I think the speed factors in the most.
Well, he gets to balls that get by most people at that position. Just really impressive, because there's certain times the ball comes off the bat, automatically that team that hit it thinks that they've got a base hit, or they may have extra bases, and he just takes it away.
Fly ball down the line. O'Neill gets under it. O'Neill pulls it down.
The right fielder, number 10, Ramon Laureano.
So first and second with two outs. And now the right fielder, Ramon Laureano. The 1-1 is fouled off. First and second, two down. Top half of inning number four. That's inside. Two balls, two strikes.
That one called just inside, I think, and on the mound, he's trying to get a little bit of an explanation. Doesn't seem to be too bothered by it, though, but he clearly thought it clipped the corner.
Two on, two outs. Bounced out to short. Story. Tosses to first. That's out number three. Guardians strand a couple. They lead 4-0. Back here at Fenway, and here is Devers. He's a guy who does it all. With the lack of contact in today's game, this guy hits for contact, so he delivers average, but there's on base and slugging too.
Early in the count, you have to be real careful because of that power, but then if this hitter gets a strike or two on him, he's still very comfortable, and because he has the ability to get the barrel to the baseball, he's a threat deep into the count as well.
The pitch. Swing and a miss, struck him out.
Now batting, first baseman,
Tristan Casas, up next for the Red Sox. Two balls and a strike. Here it comes. Popped up. Rocchio makes the grab, two down.
The batter, number 7, designated hitter, Masataka.
And next will be the cleanup hitter, Masataka Yoshida. And another ball.
Recognize that changeup right out of the hand. Just spit on it.
On the ground, Giménez. Over to first, and it's a 1-2-3 inning. Nothing doing for Boston. They trail it here, 4-0. We're back, and there's a new arm on the mound to start the fifth. Zach Kelly. So the lineup flips over, stepping up for the Guardians, Stephen Kwan. 1-2 now. Got him looking. Called strike three and a fastball up in the zone.
Now that is the seventh field.
And now, Miles Straw. This is a guy who's in the lineup first and foremost because of what he contributes defensively, Chris. And when you talk about preventing runs from being scored, this guy is a big contributor. And there's a hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
Well, I don't think that pitch would have been called a strike, but he did such a nice job of pulling his hands tight to the body and just getting enough of the barrel on it to be hard enough back up the middle for a knock.
And now the first baseman shot, and they got him.
I don't know if he was looking to go right there or not, but he was clearly fooled by the pickoff move. Quick feet, quick release over there by the pitcher. Really quick tag as well.
That one to first, Casas. Tosses to the pitcher covering the bag, and that is the inning. Ready to go for the last half of the inning. And stepping in for Boston, Trevor Story. The Red Sox in striking distance, but have some work to do.
Boog, it starts with the leadoff man. I need a good at-bat out of him right here.
Here comes a pitch. Now, Red Sox fans are frustrated, no question. 2-2 on the way. And another ball.
Now in this three-ball count, down in the ball game, you've got to be very selective. Take your walk if they'll give it to you.
And it's ball four. He missed down low.
It's tough after falling behind a hitter, two balls and no strikes. But now at least he gets a fresh start against a new batter. But he needs to get back into the strike zone and start pitching with conviction. If you're going to get something going, this is the time to do it. You get the leadoff man on. Everybody's got to look over the shoulder and say, I'm just going to keep the line moving. Don't try to do too much.
That one not close. Now two balls and a strike. Swing and a pop-up. Foul territory for the catcher. Naylor makes the grab, one away.
Now batting, left fielder, Tyler
O'Neill. Man at first, and next for the Red Sox, Tyler O'Neill. And he deals. And that one wrapped foul. And the pitch. That one down the line, and that's just foul. Righty delivers.
3-2.
Deep left field, and forget it. He sends it out of here. It's 4-2. He kept swinging, and it paid off.
Well, that was a battle, Boog, and he just kept taking his cuts. Finally squared one up. You have a team that hits home runs at such a high rate, they can get back in the ball game so quickly. That's why that leadoff walk was extremely costly.
One down. Still stepping in for Boston, Vaughn Grissom. The wind of the pitch. Hard hit left side. to first. Oh. And there are two down. Connor Wong up next for the Red Sox. The 1-1. Just missed. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Emmanuel Clase, the anchor of the staff, is getting ready to close this one out. Barlow also throwing. The Red Sox trailing by two. Last half of inning number five. In the air, right field. Laureano settles under it. Makes the grab, and that's the inning. But not before they're able to draw closer with this blast. It's now 4-2. Back after this on the show. Back in Boston, start of the sixth, John Ciambi with Chris Singleton. And leading off, Jose Ramirez. Right-handed reliever. Big swing and a miss.
One ball, two strikes.
And a 1-2. Gets a piece and stays alive. And now one away. And next is the designated hitter, Will Brennan. Base is empty, one away, and we're the top half of the sixth. That one fouled off, 2-2.
Clearly trying to stay back a little bit longer for that changeup as he fouls that fastball back.
Now two out.
Well, he throws him with the changeup right there, and I think he was so geared up for fastball once he recognized that it was off speed, he just wasn't able to make an adjustment. So a really good strikeout, and the pitcher just won the battle.
Two down, nobody on. Got him looking. And a nice inning of work there as he sets him down, 1-2-3.
Impeccable command in that one. Three batters, three strikeouts. That's electric stuff out there on the mound.
Back now for the bottom of the sixth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, Sam Hentges.
These are the spots relievers really make a name for themselves, late and close. There's not much margin for error, but at the same time, there's a reason they're put in these situations.
So the batting order turns over. Now here's the Red Sox leadoff hitter, Jaren Duran. The 1-1. Swing and a pop-up in foul ground. Naylor drifts towards it, puts it away for the out.
Now batting, third baseman, Rafael Devers.
Now it's Devers at the plate. The lefty fires. And another ball. Next pitch misses, and that's ball three.
Way to lay off that fastball up right there. You're looking for something you see well that you can handle, but you also have to keep the discipline so that you're not popping up pitches that are just a little too high. Well, he tried to nibble right there and just missed his spot. Hitter didn't offer at it. Now he has somebody to worry about over at first. Now, these guys definitely looking for a big swing of the bat right here. Try to close that gap. But, you know, at the very least, if you could find a way to manufacture that run from first, it feels like it's really important, like getting back into this ballgame. Going to really need to hang in there with that front side against this left-handed breaking ball.
Tying run at the plate. That ball is foul, and the pressure is building.
Just missed. If he's able to connect on that, look out.
And here it comes. Fouls it off, still 1-2. With the tying run at the plate, here in the bottom of the sixth. Foul ball still, 1-2 count. Left-hand hitter waits. Fights it off. You'll see another. He fouls it off. We'll do it again. The pitch. Not even close there. And the count is even, 2-2. About to see the 11th pitch of the at bat here. And misses. It's a strikeout.
Just a hammer 12-6 curveball right there, Bo. That was exactly what he wanted to do with it. Not a ton of pitchers can throw a true 12-6 break, but he does, and you can't throw it any better than he did right there.
Masataka Yoshida now at the plate. And now 2-1. Left-hand batter waits.
Three balls.
In the dirt. No advance. Three balls and a strike. Two outs. And the tying run is on base.
Not what he wanted to do there, Bo. He keeps this inning alive and gives this offense a good chance to cut into their deficit.
The Guardians going with a new pitcher, Scott Barlow.
Well, the best relievers love the opportunity to come in and protect the tight lead late in the ball game. Some of them are just wired different, so we'll see what he's got here.
Looks like we've got a substitution at second, and here's the pinch runner, Bobby Dalbec. Trevor Story comes up to the plate. First and second, two down. That misses, and that's ball two.
It's a big opportunity right here, but I love the way he's slowing the game down. He's shrinking his zone, making sure he gets the pitch that he wants to hit.
Soft contact in the air, and it drops in. Here's the throw to the plate. Save! He scores, and it's a one-run game.
Such great concentration. Everybody on their feet, knowing that you can come through with a good swing. And there, he doesn't try to do too much.
So two down. Willier Abreu digs in now. So the tying run at second. Bounding ball here rolls foul.
Well, if he's going to do something special right here, it's going to happen with two strikes.
The 1-2. Got him! They limit the damage here.
A lot of adrenaline, we can see it right there, and sometimes you just got to let it out. That's an outstanding job of taking that, executing, and getting out of a tough inning.
Now, Now into the ball game on defense, Bobby Dalbec. He's the new third baseman. Brian Rocchio digs in for the Guardians.
The shortstop, Brian Rocchio.
The pitch. And strike two.
1-2-3.
High fly ball down the left field line. One up, one down.
Now back, second baseman,
Andrés Giménez digs in for the Guardians. And a 1-1. He swings and fouls one off. One down, base is empty. Fights that one away, still 1-2. Right-hander kicks, deals. High fly ball near the pole. That one is foul.
That's a really good at bat. What I like about this guy, his bat stays in the zone for a long time. Gives him the ability to foul off tough pitches.
The pitch. Fouls it off, still 1-2.
5 foul balls in a row. I have no idea what that feels like, but you got to love this battle. Just wondering who's going to blink first.
Ninth pitch of the at bat due next. Got it by him for the K. Here's Ramon Laureano.
Ramon Laureano.
And the right-hander deals. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. Two down, nobody on. Goes down looking. Nothing doing for the Guardians there, but they hold on to a 4-3 lead. We're back, and on the mound is the closer, Emmanuel Clase.
And we all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man. And one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate's very high, and it just breaks a ton.
Leading off.
And stepping in for Boston, Tyler O'Neill. Can't forget the two-run shot he launched out of here in the fifth.
Yeah, one of the biggest swings of the game, Boog, as he looks to make even more of an impact in this at-bat right here.
Looking to get the tying run on base.
Oh, an interesting situation. One swing, you can tie up the ball game. But if you're patient and work a walk, then you bring the game-winning run to the plate.
Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout. A big first out here in the seventh via the punch out.
Yeah, it just does so much to change the outlook of an important inning like this. When you got the leadoff hitter, so critical in setting the table when you got a tight game like this. So a strikeout really puts them on their heels.
And here is Vaughn Grissom. And a pitch. Smoked on the ground a second. Giménez throw to first. Only one out left for the Red Sox.
Well, there's a lot riding on that at bat right there. Nice job of the pitcher to bear down, make the pitch, get the ground ball. Excellent piece of work.
And here's the catcher, Connor Wong. Two outs. and fouled off. Classe is just one strike away. And that skips into dirt. Got him! And that is the ball game.
Sometimes road trips can be tough. You're away from your family, but when you can win, silence that opposing crowd, it makes things just a little bit better, makes the road trip just a little bit shorter.
And the final score here, 4-3. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciampi. Thanks for joining us.
The final line score for this afternoon's ball game. First, for the victorious Cleveland Guardians, 4 runs on 9 hits, no errors, they left 3 runners on base.